So today we are going to start to review different smartwatches, but mostly for their fitness tracking features. Now we are not very athletic people anyway, so it's not gonna be anything spectacular. So normal, we try to exercise every other day, maybe maximum 3 times a week. So today I have this one. It's a Vivo Active 3, but this is a special edition. They call it the Star Wars Darth Vader edition, which it's actually kind of pretty. And so we will go through it and kind of talk about the feature and how it works. I have been wearing this for a bit, so I will just show you guys how it looks like when I unpack it, and then we'll go from there. So this is the 45 millimeter casing version. I have been wearing this, that's why you see it has my watch face on it. So the watch comes with two sets of, this special edition comes with two sets of armband. Let's go show you this one. So the first one is the one that's extra is a normal silicone one. It's very nice and soft. I do like them, but then again, I always liked all of the armband that they give out. So let's put that aside. And the next thing we have here is the watch. So let's take it out. I'll kind of show you what comes in it. Let's get this off. Pretty much nothing else except for a charging cable, which has the very normal charging port that Garmin always uses. Okay. So I think I paid for 319 euro online for this, and yeah, so the prices may vary. I bought it from Germany. I think it came from UK. So as you can see, this is a trans-reflective display, which means that it does have a backlight and it can lighten up. It does have a little bit of blue haze, but what you do get, which later on the video or we have already shown it, it's how it looks in bright sunlight. So it reflects some of the lights back up to your eyes, and that way you can see it in bright sunlight. As we know, with the OLED screen, it is kind of hard sometimes to see it on the bright sunlight. If the nits are not high enough, that means the brightness is not high enough. So this one is quite a nice watch, in fact. So once you start up and get the iConnect app and set up your watch properly, then what happens is you get, this is the main watch face or the main area, which you see all your number, and you can have very many watch faces just like anything else. And as you can see, it comes with two buttons there, and of course the touch screen. So if you pull down, for mine, it's set up to be, it's my pulse ox, which measures my oxygen saturation in my blood. And of course, you have to kind of wear it for it to work. And so we'll get out of there, go back to the thing. So if you swipe up, you'll get all your little widget, they call it. And again, on the app, it's pretty simple. You can set up and you can change how they show up, or you can have it at the beginning, what your day is like, or overall outlook of what you have done. And like I said, everybody knows that Garmin's tracking is really good. And in fact, one of the things that I enjoy quite a bit is their body battery concept. It kind of works, but when it was low, I do find that I don't have much energy to do anything, and you can track your water intake and whatnot. So if you're used to Android Wear, or let's first say Apple Watch, or even the Huawei's GT2, you know that the system, the UI, is a lot more smoother. Garmin is not, but the good thing about Garmin is their tracking is amazing. So you are paying for something else, but you're not getting probably the best one. But that being said, I think it's perfectly adequate. I still get my messages here quite easily. As you can see, these are what your push notifications and your messages from your phone will show up here. And you can actually go into something. In some cases, you can dismiss it, call back, or there might be an option of even responding. So I have just cleared my messages. Let's per se, we cleared that particular message, and let's go back here. Let me show you what the watch face switching thing is kind of like. Now, one of the things that I did find that kind of annoyed me is that if you look at it, it takes a bit. So if I just do it normally, somehow takes a bit to switch to the next one. you see what I mean. It's not the smoothest, but you can just choose one and you would set it up and it would load up and whatnot. So that all works mostly fine. But keep in mind, most of these watch faces can and will have more options usually through the Connect app. So on the other side of the watch, we do have a polycarbonate, what you call, casing in the back. It's quite durable, and I think this is some sort of a scratch-proof glass. It has their standard heart rate detection and also the pulse ox stuff. The charging port, and as you can see from the looks of it, the body is also made of polycarbonate. Very good quality, and I say it's a lot lighter than something of this size made by any other manufacturer. Maybe beside Polar or somebody. I do like this special edition because of the red highlights there, and also I like the different texture on the bezel there. So all in all, it's a pretty good watch if you just a normal person like me and just like to record your stuff, which motivates you. I think it's a great watch. Today we're gonna go for a ride. Me and my wife, we try to do 15.7 kilometer ride every. I say every other day, maybe three times a week. So yeah, when I come back, we'll see how that goes.
Okay, to start an activity, press your top button once, and then you'll get a bunch of options. For me, the bike is the very top one. Once you click on that, as you can see, it will say waiting for GPS. Okay, as you can see now, once it catches the GPS signals, it will get into this mode. And then you just press the button once and it gets started. It will pause quite nicely as you're going by. My heart rate is a little bit high already, but ignore that. As you can see, it's a way to showcase how good this trans-reflective display actually works. I mean, it looks so clear and crisp in the full sun. It's really nice. Okay, so let's get going and we'll see how that goes later on. Okay, so now we're done with our workout. As you can see, still going. Just press the top button again to pause, and then it will ask you the screen. Press the top button, activity saved. And I'll give you a quick little summary, but on the Connect app from Garmin, you definitely get a lot more information there. So after this, you pretty much can go back to your regular screen and whatnot, and yeah, and next we'll go into the app and take a look at what sort of detailed information shows up.
Now we're in the activity page. So this is the particular activity we went for again. As you can see, this is the main page. It kind of shows you the overview and your maps, which also allows you to go into it and zoom in and take a look at your exact path. It's quite precise in my opinion. But we'll get out of that and we'll go over to the next tab, and then you start seeing what sort of information that you get. Keep in mind, you can also download the Garmin's app on your PC, and that does give you more access to the raw data as far as I know. Okay, so as you can see, you will get a lot of information here in terms of your elevation, heart rate, timing. But if you wanted to, if you're more of a visual person, you can also go into the graphs. In that case, it will show you how your different things are good doing, and you can set up different zones for your heart. And so you can see that most of the time, I'm not the most healthiest person. So you see, I've gone a little bit into zone 5, but most of the time I spent in zone 4. I think I'm not feeling so well as well, so that why it's kind of shows that. And it also shows your automatic laps that it sets up. So there is a lot of information. Not to say that you don't get it with the other manufacturers, but with Garmin you get consistency. I must say that this is a very good choice for anybody who is thinking about getting into fitness again, or just wants to start tracking their health. Give this a start, and I think if you are serious about this and you want the precision, go with Garmin. And then if you do like newer watches, then you can stick with Garmin and you will get, you know, the same sort of experience all the time. Last thing I wanted to show is the Connect IQ app, which is like Garmin's app store On that, what you mostly get is their the welcome page. On that one, you can go by, okay, you want to look at new watch faces. There is a lot there, and also new apps and widgets that help you track and show your things at a glance. So all in all, it's pretty self-explanatory. There's one way up you can customize some of your watch faces and also get more information here. About how many spots are open. So this is what I was talking about, installed apps versus how many holes that were still remaining to put apps or watch faces in. That's one of the things. So I guess it's limited to 31, I suppose. So you can do a lot of things here, but mostly it is used as a app store. And all in all, that's all I have to say. Give it a go and see if you like it, and hopefully in the future I'll come up with more reviews of fitness watches.